हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो माई सेल्फ ज्योतिर्मयी फ्रॉम ओशन ऑफ नॉलेज. ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. ओके, सो न्यूटन, सर आइज़क न्यूटन हैज़ गिवन थ्री लॉज ऑफ मोशन. ओके, ही हैज़ गिवन थ्री लॉज ऑफ मोशन. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. ओके, सो according to Newton's third law of motion, to every action there is always an equal and opposite reaction. Okay, so Sir Isaac Newton has told that to every action there is always an equal and opposite reaction. Equal and opposite reaction. So let us understand it. What does it mean? What does the statement mean? Okay, so for example, suppose two bodies are colliding with each other. This is A and this is B. Okay, so when these two bodies are colliding, the body A will exert a force on the body B due to its mass. So that force is known as, let it be FBA. This stands for the force on B exerted by A. Okay, so according to Newton's law this is the action force that A is putting on the B. Okay, so an equal and opposite force, which is a reaction force, an equal and opposite reaction force will be exerted by the body B on the body A. And that force is known as FAB. FAB. That is the force on A exerted by B. So according to Newton's law, FAB is equal to minus of FBA. FAB is equal to minus of FBA. Now what does this minus sign signify? This minus sign signifies that both the forces are opposite to each other. Opposite in direction. Understood? So minus sign implies that both the forces are opposite in direction, and equal to sign implies that both the forces are equal in magnitude. Okay? So this is the Newton's third law of motion, which is very, very simple. Okay? So let us understand some examples of it. Okay? You can take a screenshot of this. Okay? Okay, so let us understand some examples. So first example that I am giving is, number one, okay, a book kept on a table. Okay, the book kept on a table. Suppose एक table के ऊपर एक book रखा गया है, ठीक है? ये suppose एक table है. And we have kept a book here. Okay, so what happens? The book will exert a force to the downward direction from its center of gravity point. From its center of gravity, the book will exert a downward force. Downward force equal to its weight. The book will exert a downward force equal to its weight. And that force will be known as F, which is equal to M into G. Okay. So to balance this force, the table will exert an opposite reaction force on the book. Okay, so the table will exert from its center of gravity. Table ka jo center of gravity point hai, table uska center of gravity ke point se ek upward force exert karega. Which is called as the reaction force. That will be equal to F according to Newton's third law of motion. Understood? That means F is equal to R, but its direction is opposite. Opposite. That's why we have put a minus sign there. Understood? And the most important thing to be understood here or to be kept in mind is that both the force and the reaction force, that is, this is the action force and this is the reaction force. This is action and reaction. Both the action and reaction never act on the same point. Okay, they never act on the same point. Like I have said here, the action force is coming from the center of gravity of the book. Understood? And the reaction force is coming from the center of gravity of the table. Okay, that means action force ka origin kahan se ho raha hai? Book se. And reaction force ka origin kahan se ho raha hai? Table se. Okay, so they are never acting on the same object. Action and reaction force are never acting on the same object. It should be kept in mind. So I am keeping it a star mark that action and reaction never act on the same object. Okay, next we come to a second example. Suppose this is a wall. Okay, this is a wall and a man is pushing this wall. Suppose a man is pushing this wall. Okay. Though it will not move, but he is pushing. Means he is putting some force on the wall. So that force, let the force be F. So the wall will also exert an equal and opposite force on its palm, on the palm of the man. Means the wall will also exert an equal and opposite force on the palm of the man. Okay, so here also F will be equal to R, but it will be of opposite direction. Okay, next, another thing that I can say here, if the force that is acting downwards in case of this example becomes greater than the reaction force, if the force coming from or the exerted by the book on the table is greater than the reaction force, then what happens? The book will fall down. And if they are equal, then only the book will be in the state of equilibrium. If both the forces are equal, then only the book will be in the state of equilibrium. Understood? Okay. So next we will go to the third example. suppose next example is motion of a boat. Motion of a boat moving away from the shore. Motion of a boat moving away from a shore. For example, suppose this is a boat. And here a person is sitting. And here is the shore. This is the shore. Okay, and this is the boat. And the person is holding an oar. This is the oar. And he is sitting here. Okay, so what happens in this case? How the action and reaction force acts in this example? You see, what happens when the person has to move forward? When the person has to move forward, means here water is present. Okay. When the person has to move forward, this boatman, he is the boatman. Okay. So this boatman will exert a force in this direction. The boatman will exert a force on the shore in this direction so that he can move forward. So what makes the boat move forward? So what makes the boat move forward? That is the reaction force exerted by the shore. Understood? That is the reaction force exerted by the shore on the boat as well as on the boatman. Okay? So the force is acting along this direction. So the shore, according to the Newton's third law of motion, will exert an equal and opposite force on the boat. Will exert an equal and opposite force on the boat along with the boatman, which will make the boat to move forward. Which will make the boat and the boatman to move forward. Understood? So here also F is equal to minus of R. Then only the boat will move forward. Understood? Like this the boat moves away from the shore. Then next example, number 4 example, we can say firing a bullet from a gun. Firing a bullet from a gun. So what happens here? Suppose a gun suppose this to be a gun. Okay, and here from here a bullet is fired. From here a bullet is fired. Okay, so when you are firing a gun, then the gun is exerting an accelerating force on the bullet. The gun is exerting an accelerating force on the bullet, due to which the bullet moves forward at a great speed, at a greater velocity. Okay, so this is called as the action force. This is called as the action force. So according to Newton's third law, this bullet will also exert an equal and opposite force on the gun, but in the backward direction. But in the backward direction, which is called as the reaction force. So you must have seen that when a person fires a bullet, or you must have experienced in the fair mein bhi girta hai na, shooting. Balloon and all. So that you must have experienced when you are holding a gun and you are firing. Okay, so when the bullet moves, a recoil of the gun is experienced. A recoiling of the gun is experienced at the backward direction. Bullet aage chala jayega, lekin tum log ko ek backward force mehsoos hoga piche ki taraf. Wo jo backward force tum log ko feel hota hai, that is due to the reaction force. That is due to the reaction force. Understood? Which is created due to the action force. Which is created due to the action force. Understood? So here also F is equal to minus of R. Understood? So this is the recoiling force, you can say. This is the recoiling force. And this is the accelerating force. This is the accelerating force. Understood? Now let us go to the next example. So next example is of rocket motion. So what happens in case of rocket, you see? In case of rocket, okay, you can see below there is a diagram very nicely. There has been described how the force and reaction force is acting. So see what happens in case of rocket motion. When the rocket is moving, okay, inside the gases or the inside the fuels are burnt up. Inside the fuels are burnt up, which creates up a high temperature and a high pressure, which creates up a high temperature and a high pressure, due to which the gases are moving backward through this nozzle. Due to which the gases are moving backward through this nozzle. So they are creating or they are exerting a force in the backward direction. They are exerting a force in the backward direction. This force is created due to the evolution of the gases or due to the expulsion of the gases due to the high temperature and the high pressure. Okay, so this force exerts an equal and opposite reaction force, or due to this force, an equal and opposite reaction force is created in the forward direction. Is created in the forward direction, which helps the rocket to move forward. Understood? When the rockets are moving, okay, so what happens? The fuels present inside the rocket, that is burnt up, which creates up a high pressure and high temperature. As a result of high pressure, the gases has to be expelled out through this nozzle, and as a result of this, these gases are exerting a large force to the backward direction. So according to Newton's third law, an equal and opposite reaction force will be exerted in the forward direction, which will help the rocket to move forward. Understood, students? Okay. So next example, number 6 is example, we can take of a motion of a man. Motion of a man on ground. So what happens here, you see, suppose a person is walking, you can see below, the diagram has been very nicely described. He is walking on the floor, okay, he is walking on the floor. So what happens, when he is walking, he is exerting a force on the ground, but in the up, that is backward direction. He is exerting a force, okay, he is exerting a force on the ground, or he, you can say the foot, our foot, when we are walking on the ground, the foot is pushing the ground backward. Okay, so as a result of which, the ground is exerting an equal and opposite reaction force in the forward direction. Understood? हम लोग जब walk करते हैं, तो हम लोग का foot ग्राउंड को पीछे की तरफ पुश करता है, एंड एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ विच द ग्राउंड एक्सर्ट्स एन इक्वल एंड ऑपोजिट रिएक्शन फोर्स अलोंग द फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन, एंड दैट फोर्स वी कॉल इट एज अ फ्रिक्शन, ओके. सो दिस इज द एक्शन फोर्स दैट आवर फुट इज एक्सर्टिंग ऑन द ग्राउंड, ओके, एंड an equal and opposite force will be exerted in the forward direction. This is the reaction force. An equal and opposite force will be exerted by the ground. On the foot, due to which we are moving forward. And that force we call it as a friction. That means you can say, while walking, friction helps us for walking. Friction is the force which is helping us for walking. If the road will be slippery or if the road is very smooth, then it will be not so easy to walk. We will slide on the road. Okay, so we may fall down. So what helps to walk? Friction helps to walk on the ground. Remember this. Okay, so this is the sixth example. Understood? you have understood all the examples here. Okay, so if there is any doubt, you can comment me, okay, and you can ask the doubts there. And if you have understood the concept, then please do like, share and subscribe my channel. Okay, thank you.